Good morning. Today we'll see about network layer switching and comparison between circuit switching and packet switching.
What is the difference between switching and routing? Yeah, so switching is layer 2 function, whereas routing is layer 3 function. The hardware device required for switching is a switch, and the hardware device which is needed for routing is a router. Yes, switching, for switching you need a MAC address, for routing you need an IP address. Yes, so this, in case of switching, even if the destination address is not known, it will be broadcast to all the systems, and hence destination will be able to receive the frame. Whereas in case of routing, in case the destination address is not available, it will be discarded by the final router in the network. Switching is much faster than routing because switching is performed by a hardware, whereas routing is performed by means of a routing algorithm, which is a software algorithm. Okay? This is a switching network. You can see in between the source and destination, there are a number of switches which are used to forward the frame from any one source to the destination. Yes, so each one is a switch. Yes, so you can send from B to F, then you need to go through any one of the paths. Say from B to F, you can either go from B to 1, 4, 7, 6, and F, or you can go from 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, and F. Yes, so here before transmitting, usually in case of switching, the path between the sender and receiver will be fixed. Yes, all subsequent frames will be sent only through that path. Yes, so normally we call it as circuit establishment. Yes, so you can see the basics of circuit switching. In case of circuit switching, we have a dedicated communication path between two stations, as I said. Yes, so before transmission, there are three phases, namely circuit establishment, data transfer, and circuit disconnect. Yes, that means you have some data to transmit, then source is some A and destination is some F, then you will try to find a suitable path which is currently free. Yes, so that is called as a circuit. Yes, so once that circuit is established, all other data transmitted will be transmitted only through the same path. After all data has been transmitted, the circuit will be disconnected. That's the concept of circuit switching. Normally it is similar to our audio phone. Yes, so when you ring someone and then connection is established, yes, so both of you talk. Yes, you talk to your friend, then your friend talks to you. What happens is, even though you don't talk, but still you don't switch off the connection, what happens is nobody else can talk with you. Say you dial your friend and you just stay quiet, even then nobody else will be able to call you. It will be they will be getting some engaged tone. Yes, so what is happening, the bandwidth is getting wasted here. So that is the disadvantage. So that is the advantage now. Yes, so after getting connected, the transfer is transparent because you know this is the source, this is the destination, this is the path through which your frames will be transmitted. So it is inefficient because when there is no data, then also the circuit is connected and nobody else is able to use the circuit. Yes, and as you know, there is some connection set up at the beginning. It will take some time. Yes, say you want to send from A to F, establishing that connection itself will take some time. Yes, so what is circuit difference in case of circuit switching? How you can route the frames? Yes, so you can either go by static routing or dynamic routing or alternate routing. Yes, so what's the difference between these three is, in case of static routing, from A to X, the route will be static. Once you finalize the intermediate switch as 3, 4, and 7, it will be always 3, 4, and 7 for rest of the transmission, that is static routing. Dynamic routing, the routing depends on traffic. Yes, suppose on light load it will take one path. Yes, on heavy load it may can take another path. Yes, so that is dynamic routing. Yes, alternate routing, it will allow different set of routes to be used at different time. For example, if suppose A wants to transmit to X during morning time, we assume that the traffic will be relatively less. Yes, so therefore we will prefer shorter route. In case of afternoon time, we expect the traffic to increase. Yes, so we'll assign some longer route so that they can make use of the circuit for longer duration. Yes, so that is the circuit switching. Here the requirement for circuit switching is efficiency and resilience. Yes, so what do you mean by resilience? Resilience is in case the circuit fails, it will recover on its own. Yes, so you can be assured that it will recover on its own. Yes, so here you can see the alternate routes. Yes, so from same X to Y you have got various routes. Yes, in case of alternate routing, you can use one route in the morning, other route in the afternoon, other route in evening, and other route during weekend. It's all depends on traffic. In order to increase the performance, you can change the route. Yes, so next we'll see the basics of packet switching. Yes, so in case of packet switching, what happens is if the message is longer, the same as fragmentation, it will be divided into smaller messages because you cannot transmit a 10 MB message at a stretch. Yes, depending upon the bandwidth available, yes, you will divide always the entire message to be sent into smaller packets. Yes, so every switching node will receive that particular message, it will store, and then will finally find an outgoing link and then transmit. Yes, so the difference between circuit switching and packet switching is, in circuit switching you will just fix a path in the beginning, all other packets will go through the same path, whereas in case of packet switching, what happens is it uses store and forward. Yes, so the intermediate device will store the message, will find the next path currently available, and then will forward. The next node will again store and then try to find an available path and then forward. Yes, so it is more efficient than circuit switching because we don't waste bandwidth, we don't waste time in forming the circuit. Yes, this method we used by packet switching is called a store and forward. This method is normally used in any internet communication. Yes, so in packet switching also we have both virtual circuit as well as datagram switching. Yes, remember the first thing what we saw is circuit switching. Now we are seeing about packet switching. In packet switching also we have two techniques. One is virtual circuit method and another is datagram method. Yes, this datagram method is used in case of internet. In case of IP, we call similar to frames, every packet, IP packet, no, we call it technically as datagrams. Yes, so here in case of datagram switching, every packet is treated independently. Yes, it is not associated with the packet which has been sent already or which are yet to be sent. Yes, so every packet can be transmitted in its own path. Yes, so the packets can arrive out of order. Yes, so these are all, every attribute is important. Yes, so because you can always send a packet one, then send packet 2, 3, 4, etc. But the destination, since packet one will take one route, packet two will take a different path, packet three will take a different path, the final destination, the packet will arrive out of order and the destination has to rearrange that packet. So it's like our post. Yes, so circuit switching, I told, like telephone system, this is like a postal system. Yes, so you have some 10 posts. Today you post one letter, tomorrow you post one letter, day after tomorrow you post one letter. Yes, so because of rain, today's post, it doesn't get delivered. Yes, the next day you send post, you have a train during that time, therefore it reaches on time. Yes, so the second letter arrives before the first letter. The same thing happens with packet switching. So it is the responsibility of the destination to reorder the packets. Yes, there is chance that packet goes missing. Yes, because we don't wait for an acknowledgement before we send the next packet. Yes, so already we have seen this in case of flow control. So it is up to the receiver to reorder this packet. Yes. So this is about datagram. The next method, remember, packet switching uses store and forward. Yes. So in case of datagram also, it used store and forward. Packet switching virtual circuit board also, it will use the store and forward method. Yes. So virtual circuit is very similar to circuit switching. The only difference is it uses store and forward method. Yes. So the route here, like circuit switching, it is also a pre-planned route. It is established before any packet is sent, and then a call establishment request will be sent, and call accept packet. Yes, so another packet will be sent to accept that request, and then this connection establishment procedure is called as handshake. Yes, so every packet will have a virtual circuit. What is a virtual circuit number is from X to Y, you have a path, say, between switches 1, 5 and 7. Yes, so this 1, 5 and 7, this path between X and some Y with intermediate switches as 1, 5 and 7 will have a circuit identifier, say, as number 13. Yes, so every packet sent will be having that circuit switch number as 13. Yes, because when you say 13, it automatically indicates this path. So all packet with virtual circuit number as 13 will go through the same path. Yes. Here there is no routing decision required, because when you as in case of the previous datagram switching, when you make a routing decision, at every intermediate hop some time is wasted. Here the initially time is wasted during connection establishment, but subsequent packets, it will not have a destination number. Instead, it will have a virtual circuit number. So both has its own advantages and disadvantages. So at the end of transmission, you don't want to use the circuit anymore, then you send a clear request to drop the circuit. Yes, so here the advantage is you can change the path. Yes, so for you can have multiple virtual circuit to change the path. Yes, so here's the comparison between virtual circuit and datagram. In case of virtual circuit, the network can provide sequencing and error control. Yes, so you can have, to certain extent, reliability. Yes, so in datagram, every packet takes a different route, therefore there is no guarantee that packet 1 will arrive before packet 2. Yes, so in case of virtual circuit, packets are forwarded fast, you know, as the as it takes the pre-planned path. No routing decisions need to be made. Yes, so here it is less reliable in case of circuit failure or loss of node. Yes, so all the packets sent through that path will be lost, whereas in datagram there is no setup phase. So in case of sending small data, yes, you can prefer datagram approach. Even larger data, if you don't mind reliability, you can go for datagram approach, because we call this datagram approach as best effort protocol. Yes, so though there is no guarantee that the packet will reach the destination, because of the built-in error and flow control, we call it as a best effort protocol because it takes its best effort to deliver the packet. Yes, so it is flexible and routing can be used to avoid any congestion. Yes, packet switching, the virtual circuit packet size. Yes, so you see after this is the maximum size you can send. Yes, if number of packet to be sent is one, then the message size can be bigger. Yes, if you want to send more packets from your source to destination, probably you can split the space among the two packets. Yes, or three packets or four packets. It all depends on how many packets you are going to send. Yes, so this is a comparison between circuit switching, virtual circuit packet switching, and datagram packet switching. This is a very important, mostly if you write an exam, this is a mandatory question. Yes, for your final exam. Yes, so circuit switching, virtual circuit packet switching, and datagram packet switching. Yes, so what is the difference between these three approaches? Yes, so you know, here you can see in case of circuit switching, initially there is a call request signal sent. Yes, so and then this say from X it is sent to intermediate system one. Yes, so one will find a suitable next hop, say it is five will find a suitable next hop seven. Yes, and now it has fixed a path 1, 5, and 7 to reach the destination. Yes, so you can see this setup phase, it takes some time because you always have certain delay in network. Yes, few of the delay are mentioned here, which are propagation delay and processing delay. Propagation delay is the time between receiving the first bit of a packet and the last bit of a packet. Yes, so that depends upon the bandwidth. Processing delay is after getting the packet, it should see what is the content of the packet, what it is expected to do. So that is called as processing delay. So only after this delay it can find the next hop. Yes, so you can see here the call setup phase, it takes some delay. Yes, so now this call is established. Yes, and this established path is confirmed by means of call accept signal. This is the call request signal, which is acknowledged by means of the call accept signal. Yes, so then you can see data transfer is very smooth. You don't have any issue, you don't have any waiting time, you don't have any processing time. Only delay is the propagation delay. Yes, because all the packets will take the same path to reach the destination. Yes, so after all data has been transmitted, so you can have the acknowledgement signal. Yes, so and finally you can release the call after transmitting all data. Yes, so the second approach, it is the packet switching approach. Yes, the difference between circuit switching and virtual circuit packet switching is only difference is store and forward. Yes, so you can see here every packet or every frame sent will be stored and then will be forwarded on the best path. Yes, so it's not the best path, it takes the same path but still uses store and forward for increased performance. Yes, so you can see here in case of virtual circuit packet switching, the call request packet is sent and call accept packet is sent. You see here it directly goes through the established path to the source, whereas here you can see it is stored in intermediate system and then it is forwarded. Here through the packets are divided into smaller packets and then using store and forward, it is forwarded through that path. Yes, so at the end acknowledgement packet also is sent using store and forward technique. Yes, so this is the datagram packet switching approach, where you divide the packets into smaller packets. You transmit, say X transmits to some intermediate A. A finds a suitable path, stores it, finds a suitable path, and then sends to some packet one through some X, packet two some Y, packet 3, some EZ, and finally in the destination you can see packet 3 will arrive before packet 1 and 2. It's because every packet is taking a different route. Yes. So now we have seen or we have compared circuit switching, virtual circuit packet switching, and datagram packet switching. The vital difference is the time taken to transmit. Yes. So switching is one of the a major approach. Circuit switching can be compared to your voice transmission through telephone, and packet switching datagram can be compared to your postal service. Yes. So here there is call establishment delay, whereas here you don't have any call establishment delay. The difference between circuit switching and virtual circuit packet switching is that it uses store and forward. Yes. So always at the end, this PPT has been taken from William Stalling's Data and Computer Communication. Yes. Yes. Thank you.